Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a knit seamless pattern swatch, and then three different ways how to recolor that swatch, all in Adobe Illustrator. We're going to be using the Click to Exclude Pathfinder tool, and I wanted to first explain to you how it works. If you have overlapping objects that are selected on the artboard, and you click on them with the Click to Exclude tool, Illustrator is going to remove the parts that are overlapping and turn the remaining parts into a compound path. So I have some examples here. I have two stars. They're in front of a rectangle. I'll select the three pieces and come over to the Properties panel in the Pathfinder area. This is the Click to Exclude tool. I'll click here, and Illustrator has removed the overlapping parts, but it's turned what's remaining into the blue color that the stars were, because the stars were in front of the rectangle. Now I have the same stars here, but the rectangle is in front, so I'll select these and come back over and click on the Click to Exclude Pathfinder, and this time Illustrator removes the stars, but it has retained the black color because that black rectangle was in front. All right, well, that's easy to understand, but what about an invisible rectangle? Well, in this case here, the rectangle is in front. We can come over to the Layers panel and you can see that. Here's the rectangle on top and then the two stars underneath it. When I click on the Click to Exclude, Illustrator removes the stars, but now this entire design has taken on the invisible color or lack of color of that rectangle which was in front. Now the last example has the stars in front and the rectangle in back. We'll make sure by looking here, yes, the rectangle is down below the stars. So when I click on Click to Exclude, I lose the stars and the rectangle is turned black. So just remember, the compound path is going to take on the color of the objects that are in front. All right, now let's move to a blank document and we'll get started. First, I'll get the ellipse tool. It's located on the left toolbar underneath the rectangle tool. I'll press down to get the flyout menu. Here's the ellipse tool. Keyboard shortcut is L. And I'll click on the artboard to open the ellipse dialog box. And I'm going to type in 0.35 inches for the width, tab down and type in 1 inch for the height, and say OK. Now I want a black fill here, and we'll leave the 1 point stroke, and then I want points on my ellipse. So I'm going to go over to the left toolbar, and here underneath the pen tool, when I press down, I have the flyout menu, and here's the anchor point tool. So I'll select this and click on the top anchor and the bottom anchor. Now we're going to rotate this object. Let me get the selection tool first and click down to deselect the object, and then I'm going to select it again so that I can use the transform area in the properties panel. And this little angle is where the rotate tool is, so I'm going to highlight that zero and type in 24 degrees and press the return key. I want to copy this object, so I'm going to hold the Option key down and drag to make the copy, and I'm going to hold the Shift key down because I want these objects to be in the same horizontal line. Then I'll release my mouse, and I'm going to come over to this transform area and click on the icon that flips the object horizontally. So this right object is now mirroring the left object. Now I want these objects to be really close to each other without touching. So I'm going to use my left arrow key on my keyboard and just move in very small increments. Now the arrow keys on your keyboard may move your object further than mine is moving, and that's because I've changed the default setting of those keys. To do that, you can come up to Illustrator, Settings, General, and right here is where the keyboard increment is set. I've set mine to 0.01 inches, and you may want to do the same for this project. I'll say OK, and then I'm going to keep moving with that left arrow until I just see a very small space in between these two objects. And I'll click here, and that looks perfect. Now I'm going to select both of these objects, and we're going to copy them together. So I'll hold the Option key down as I drag down, and I'll hold the Shift key so that I'm dragging in a perfectly vertical line. And I want to move these until they're very, very close, and then release my mouse. Now, I don't want to use my arrow key here. That's why it's important to get the placement right, because I want to duplicate this move so I have the same space in between all of these objects. So with this object still selected, I'll use the keyboard shortcut Command-D to duplicate the move, and I'll make 3 more copies. And now we're well on our way to creating our design. What we need next is a bounding box to show Illustrator what part of the design we want repeated over and over again in our Seamless Pattern Swatch. And incidentally, if you've made other Seamless Pattern Swatches or watched some of my videos, you may have used a complete square for your pattern swatch. In this instance, it may surprise you, but that's not going to be necessary. So what we want to include is everything basically from the top part of this second left object all the way down to the top right anchor of this bottom right object. Now, in order for Illustrator to recognize a bounding box, it's got to be invisible. So let's come over and get the rectangle tool. The keyboard shortcut is M, and we'll remove the fill color and remove the stroke color. Now I'm going to start right up here at that left anchor, but instead of looking for the word anchor, I'm going to be looking for intersect, because I want to make sure I get the full left side of these objects. Now, if you're not seeing the little lines and the word intersect, you don't have smart guides turned on, and you can turn those on by going up to view. And right here is where you turn those on. You can toggle them on and off with the keyboard shortcut Command-U. I typically leave mine turned on. So we start with the top left corner, drag down to this bottom right corner. Now here I'm showing I'm right at that anchor, but I want to go a little bit further outside the anchor to the right, because I need to add some space for in between each of my columns. I'll stop here and release my mouse, but I actually want to get a little bit closer here, so I'm going to get the direct selection tool, that's keyboard shortcut A, and I'll click on this top anchor, hold down my shift key so I can click on this anchor here as well, and then I'll press down with my left arrow key until I'm almost next to the design. I like that spacing, so I'm going to leave the bounding box like that. Now there's one last thing I have to do in order for Illustrator to recognize this as a bounding box. I've got to move that invisible box behind the design. So I'll come up to Object, Arrange, over and down to Send to Back. And now I'll grab all of this and move it over out of the way. I can actually remove these bottom two pieces because they're outside of the bounding box. And then I'll come up to Window, and we've got to get the Swatches panel. And I'll select the design with the bounding box behind the design and drag and drop it into the Swatches panel next to these other swatches. Now it doesn't look like a swatch because it's not filling up the thumbnail, but when I come over and get the rectangle tool and drag out a rectangle and click on the pattern swatch, look what happens. We have a seamless pattern swatch that's filling up the rectangle just perfectly. Now I feel like the design is a little big for this rectangle, so I'm going to come up to Object, Transform, Scale, and I'm going to scale it at 35%, but I don't want to transform the object, just the patterns. So I'll uncheck Transform Objects and say OK. Now we're close to having the knit pattern swatch I showed you at the beginning of the video. We have one step left to go. So I'll get that selection tool and I'll select all of the design, which includes the objects that are in front and the invisible bounding box, which is behind them. And I'll come over to the properties panel and click on the click to exclude tool. Illustrator removes the overlapping parts, which were our design, and fills that background with black. Now all I have to do is ungroup this. Let's come up to Object and ungroup. Keyboard shortcut is Shift Command G. Then I can select the top part that's outside the bounding box and delete it, and grab the bottom part and delete it. Now I'll select this, and I don't even have to group it because Illustrator has turned it into a compound path. I will tell you that if you try to grab this from the excluded part, it's not going to move. You have to actually click on a part that's black, then you can drag and drop it into the swatches panel. Now I'll select the rectangle and select our new pattern swatch. And that, to me, just is beautiful. It looks perfect, and it really looks like a knit pattern. Now, we're going to want to add color to this pattern, so I'm going to show you three different ways to do that. The first way is to simply add color to your pattern. So what we would do is get the rectangle tool and start at the anchor. Drag down, and let's add this light green color. We want to remove the stroke, and we want the color behind the design. So Object, Arrange, Send to Back, keyboard shortcut, Shift Command, left bracket, and then select both of these together, drag them into the swatches panel, and select the rectangle. Then click on the new swatch, and that gives us a green knit pattern. And if that's the color you want, then that may be the way you want to go. But I want to create a pattern that I can change the color in. So I'm going to come back to the black and white option, and I'll show you a couple of ways to change this after it's been applied. So we're not going to be changing our original design. We're going to be changing what it's applied to. And the first one is the simplest. What we'll do is just make a copy of this rectangle. So I'll hold down the Option key and just drag out a copy. And then I'll select the back rectangle and click on the green. And then drag this up, place it together. And when I group them, they move around just fine. The problem with this is if you're using a lot of small pieces, I think this could get really cumbersome. I don't want two pieces, even if they're grouped together. So I'm going to add color to the object itself. And to do that, I'm going to come over into the appearance area of the properties panel and click on this ellipsis to open the appearance panel. Now, the appearance panel shows the attributes of whatever object is selected on the artboard. So this object has a black 1-point stroke, and it has a fill color that's a pattern. But I can add an additional fill color, which is the really neat thing about the appearance panel. I'm going to come down to this bottom bar and click on Add New Fill and click one time. And Illustrator duplicates the original fill that I had. Now, I don't want two of those, so I'm going to come down to the bottom fill, because if it's at the bottom of the list, it's at the back on the artboard. And I'll click here for the color swatches and click on my green, and Illustrator adds the color right to the object, and I don't have to mess around with multiple layers. And if I want to change the color after I've added it in the appearance panel, I'm able to come over to the properties panel and click on the color fill icon, and I can apply whatever color I want. And I still end up with my original design right here. Now, this is the method I prefer to use when I'm recoloring this particular pattern swatch. However, if you do choose this method and you want to resize the pattern, you're not going to be able to do it in the same manner that I showed you earlier in the video. Let me show you. I'll select this, come up to Object, Transform, Scale, and the only thing I'm able to do is scale the actual object itself, which I don't want to do. I'm going to uncheck that and come up here and change uniform, and no matter what value I put here, I'm not going to be able to change the size, so I'm going to cancel this. That doesn't mean, however, that you can't resize the pattern. What you have to do is access the pattern through the appearance panel. So I'll come back over, click on the ellipsis, and select the pattern in the top fill color. Select it, and once it's selected, then I can come up to Object, Transform, Scale, and I can change to whatever size I want. That's the one thing you'll need to remember if you want to resize the pattern swatch after you've added color in the appearance panel. And that is how you create a knit seamless pattern swatch in Adobe Illustrator. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video and learned some things about using the Click to Exclude tool and some of the other tools in Illustrator. I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.